This here is a default table block from the Gutenberg, and as you see, it offers only a few customization options, and most likely it's not good for more complex tables. Therefore, in this video I'm gonna show you a better table block plugin, which allows you to customize all sorts of stuff. You can create pre-built tables, choose between templates, or you can create your own table and customize it as you like. So if you're interested, then let's jump in. The plugin I'm gonna use in this video is called Table Block by Tableberg, so I'm gonna call it the Tableberg. It's a fairly new plugin, approximately 500 active installations, and it has a very good ratings. The free version comes with a paragraph, list, button and image blocks, but if you need star rating, styled list, icon, ribbon or custom HTML blocks to add it inside the table, then you need the pro version. And the pro version is the one you see on the screen. As you see, it says Black Friday has started earlier. If you click on the Get Deal button, you'll get the one-site license for $24, 10 sites license for $39, and unlimited sites license for $74. Those are the yearly plans, but there are also a lifetime plans. Those are on the screen right now. Now, these here are the official prices, but if you take a look at the description of this video, then there is a nice 20% discount coupon for you. Just follow the link, use the coupon, and you will get extra 20% off. There are a couple of ways for you to add the table. One, click here on the plus button and search for Tableberg. This one here. The other one, enter slash and search for Tableberg. Or third, click on this plus icon here. So, I'm gonna add a table. And first I can choose how many columns and how many rows are there. Currently you can also choose between pre-built tables, and in the future you can also import data tables, you can create WooCommerce tables, AI tables or post tables. If you open up the pre-built tables, you'll see all the current tables. Just scroll through and you'll see what's what. For example, if I like this template, I'm just gonna click on it. It will be imported with all the settings. Now I'm gonna delete it. Let's create one from scratch. So, 3 columns, 9 rows. Let's create it. And now let's take a look at the table settings. First I'm gonna open up the table itself. There is a disable header. Activate it. I'm gonna deactivate it and you'll see that the header is here. Let's add a header for the columns. Header 1, header 2 and header 3. The cell settings, whether they are fixed with cells or not. If you deactivate the fixed with cells, then you can open up the cell settings and set the width to the first column as 25%. For the second cell it's 50%, and for the last cell it's 25%. Once again, this way you can customize all the cells. You can set the orientation, whether it's horizontal or vertical. As with any other cells, you can choose blocks. But once again, star rating, styled lists, icon, ribbon and custom HTML blocks are available only for the pro version. I'm not gonna add any other blocks to the header, but I'm gonna add an image here. For example, let's add this image. Image width, 100 pixels, alignment, center, and done. Now let's add some customization to the text, and let's add another block here. For example, star rating. Number of stars, you can customize how many stars there are. I'm gonna leave it as 5. Next there is a star value and star size. I'm gonna make it a bit bigger, and let's add some star colors. Text color, let's add this one here, and this is the preview. And I'm gonna add 4 stars for this one here. Next I'm gonna add a styled list, some item here. I'm gonna duplicate some other item and duplicate once more, and done. You can select icons like this. Just choose the icon you like the most and done. Icon size 26 for this one. 20 and so on and so forth. You can customize the icon spacing, font size for the text, or set the custom size 16 for example. Inside this cell I'm gonna add another block, and this time it's a button. For example, contact us. Set the width to 100%. Add a link. I'm going to add the link to the contact page. Let's save it and let's preview it. There you go. There it is. Really fast, really simple. I'm going to once again select the table itself. And let's see what else can we do here. We can disable footer. If we activate it, then it's displayed down below here. We can make the bottom row as a footer. We can insert the footer. We can set the table width. I'm going to set it as a 100%. Table alignment, whether it's center, left, or right. I'm going to leave it as center. There are some responsive settings for the tablets. You can enable the breakpoint if needed. The same with the mobile. Enable the breakpoint if needed. Set the breakpoint max width. Mode, whether it's scroll or stack cells. Let's save it. I'm going to refresh the page, open up my mobile view, and you'll see this here is a stacked version. If I set it to scroll and save it, let's refresh it, then it displays like this. I like the stacked option more, so I'm going to add it here. Stack direction, whether it's a row or column. What else you can do here? Show header in first column, this one here, items per row. You can make the top row to be sticky or sticky first column. I'm going to go back to the desktop settings. You can enable search. It's here. Save it and refresh it. You'll see the search bar here. I'm going to close this down. And there is a search you can use. Before I proceed with the video, don't forget to smash that like button down below here. It means a lot to me and it also helps my channel. So I would appreciate your help. Next, you can enable vertical sorting. As you see, those are the sorting icons here. This is also useful for the tables with more data. There is a horizontal sorting. Let's also activate this one here. And you'll see this here is a horizontal sorting. Currently, I don't have anything to sort, but you'll see what is happening here. If you refresh the page, then it will reset. Now we can open up the styles and customize the header background color, for example, like this. You can also add gradient colors. You can add even row colors or odd row colors. I'm going to add a color for the odd rows, and it's light gray, like this one here. Borders are a bit too dark for me, so I'm going to scroll down, and I'm going to open up inner borders and change the color. It's too dark for me, so I'm going to change it a bit. I'm going to add gray color as a border. Let's save it, refresh it, and done. At the moment, I don't need the horizontal sorting, so I'm going to disable it. Otherwise, it's a bit messy for me. Okay, back to the styling options. What else you can customize? Footer background, cell background, for example, this one here for the specific cell. For this cell, let's open it up. I can customize every cell separately. I can do the same with the rows. So I can open up the cell, styling, row background, like this. If something goes wrong, I'm going to undo that. Next, you can add cell padding, cell spacing, whether it's here or here. You can set top, right, bottom, left separately or custom like this. Just a quick overview for you. There is a cell spacing option like this, useful for the pricing tables. Border options, row only borders or hide cell outside borders. Table border options, inner border options, row borders, column borders, and global font color and link colors. So, for example, global text, global link text, and done. Now, what else you can add to the cells? Let's take a look. We saw image, star rating, style list, and button. You can add an icon, for example, this one here. Or you can add custom HTML, whatever it is you would like to display here. And last one, you can add a ribbon. Let's search for ribbon. There you go. Let's add -10% as a text. Ribbon is on the left or on the right, whether it's on top or bottom. Position, you can customize it as you like. Size, ribbon type, whether it's outside, bookmark, corner, icon, or a badge. I'm gonna choose bookmark. And now instead of this column, I'm gonna drag it here. I'm gonna save it, refresh it. Next, I'm gonna change the text size a bit, save it, refresh it, and there you go. I can customize it even further, but in order to keep the tutorial short, I'm gonna leave it as it is. So, as you saw, creating a responsive table for WordPress with sorting and search options is really easy with the help of the Tableberg plugin. I really like it, so I think you may also want to give it a go. Tableberg is only one of the awesome new plugins which is out there, but I have made a separate video about other free WooCommerce plugins that nobody uses. This video is on the screen right now, so be sure to take a look at it next. In the meantime, take care.